Monsters are real. When I was a girl, my mother was murdered by a low-life coward named Gangplank. He shot me and left me for dead. There was no trial. In Bilgewater, he was the law. I hunted him. I killed his men. I watched Gangplank die, washed away on the burning tide. But there are still monsters about. For centuries, the Buru people have protected these islands from the worst of them. But even they fear the harrowings. Attacks in the form of a lethal black mist, courtesy of our unliving neighbors on the Shadow Isles. Each time, the harrowings return stronger, while the Buru grow distant. How long can we rely on prayers and magic? My monsters are flesh and blood. They don't frighten me. Only one thing does. Becoming one of them. Quiet from up here. If only I didn't know better.
Good morning, Captain. Your guest has arrived.
Raffin, remember when we could just take what we wanted, go where we wanted? We didn't have a care in the world. Now look at us. Taking appointments, attempting diplomacy.
Well, at least our line of diplomacy still involves guns.
That may be true. But when he was Reaver King, Gangplank only used guns. If I unite the gangs with violence, will the city still think of me as a savior?
Gangplank was a tyrant, Sarah. You're tough, but you aren't cruel. I'm proud to be your first mate. And the rest of the crew is proud to call you our captain. The gangs will follow you. It's only a matter of time.
They can't follow me if they're dead. Hopefully I can change their minds before they're all wiped out.
Some dogs won't obey until you show them the stick.
Well then, let's not keep Captain Thorne waiting any longer.
Thank you.
still got the bullets in my chest. Killing Gangplank wasn't enough, Raven.
But you beat him. You're still breathing. And he's in little pieces all over the bottom of the ocean. Those bullets are just little reminders.
I wish they didn't remind me so damn much.
Doing some remodeling.
What can I say? The place needed a woman's touch. I don't think the previous owner would mind.
Guess not. Seeing as how you gunned him down, along with the rest of the conclave.
Are you here to parley, Captain Thorne, or to criticize my sense of decor? I trust you've considered my offer.
Offer? Hand over my operations to you, my fleet, and all of my men, or else... Misfortune. You may have killed Gangplank, stolen his fancy manor, but that don't make you my queen. From where I'm standing, it looks like Bilgewater is still up for grabs. Now give it up, girl. You know I'd hate to ruin that pretty face.
So much for diplomacy.
You know, Raven, I think I'm starting to enjoy it.
Thank you.
consider this your formal surrender.
The Syndicate will never follow you. You hear me, tyrant? I'll die first.
I see. How about you, boys? Does your captain speak for you all? Well then, Captain Thorne. I'd say this meeting is adjourned. The rest of you, welcome to my crew. Prove yourselves loyal and you'll be rewarded. Betray me, or even whisper the name Gangplank, and I'll stuff you in a box with your former captain. Understood?
Yes, Captain.
Another successful recruitment. Minus a few stubborn holdouts, the Syndicate's with us now. Their ships, their guns.
But none of their leaders.
Not yet.
Even if I have to put a bullet in every captain from the shipyards to the slaughter docks, I will make them understand. Bilgewater belongs to Sarah Fortune.
Thank you.
Run! Leave me!
Brothers and sisters, a new enemy has risen in Bilgewater. The goddess Nagakaboros has shown him to me.
Reveal him to us, Truth-bearer.
This Blood Harbor Ripper butchers men in their homes and in the streets. I can sense the fear, the stagnation he brings. We honor the Mother Serpent by restoring motion and driving him out.
Praise the goddess.
Truth-bearer. I wish to fight for you. I am ready.
Are you? If you fight with everything you have, the Mother Serpent may name you worthy. If not, she will take your life.
I surrender to her will.
He is strong, priestess. He may live.
Perhaps, if the goddess wills it. Come, our enemy awaits. These streets are full of motion. Nagakaboros smiles upon us.
Why do you embrace these foreigners, priestess? The Pelangi do not respect the goddess or Buru tradition.
They make their own way. They fight to live. Walk among them, learn from them, maybe even have some fun.
They have many interesting desires.
Sister, I have seen you indulge in their taverns. Do not be ashamed. Next time, I will join you. Now let us follow the rhythms of the street. Here, the men inside spoke recently of the killer we seek.
We will wait outside. No need to get Pelangi stink on us.
More for me then. Pelangi stink? Why must my people be so stubborn? Can I find the Blood Harbor?
Who's asking?
I am Ilawi, truth bearer of Nagakaboros, champion of the Bulu.
Sure, lady. And I'm the River King, Tom Kench. Buzz off, try and relax.
Perhaps a display of strength will change your mind.
Sorry. I try not to get into fights with strange women in bars.
So, you're unworthy. Or just afraid.
You see this sword? I've run it through hundreds of men, most bigger than you. So how about you go on home?
I thought you would be strong. They will know me. Tell me.
No one I know has actually seen him. Rumor is he stalks the alleys around the warrens. They say he ain't alive. Not really.
Not alive?
His skin like a corpse. Cold. And his eyes are empty. Like a body pulled up from the sea.
A creature trapped between life and death. An affront to the goddess.
He has a thing for captains. Find a captain and the Ripper won't be far behind, they say.
Thank you, little man.
Hey, you want to stay a while? I never drank with a priestess before.
You break too easily.
We heard commotion.
My new Pelangi friends simply wish to learn Buru tradition. Let us search the warrens nearby.
Mm.
they will learn or they will die. Goddess flow through you. Sweetness of fruit and the joy of battle. face a truth bearer. Do better than that. They must be tested to grow. I will teach you what I can.